everyone, this is Yana Smakula, member of the Spellbinders Design Team. And today I'm sharing clean and simple Thinking of You card using the Romantic Rose die set, as well as the Pierce the Light dies and the A2 Matting Basics A set. I'm also going to be using several colors of ink from Spellbinders, which are the Luscious Lime, Pixie Play, Pretty Plum, and the Lovely Lavender. I'm going to begin working on my card by die-cutting several rose images from the Romantic Rose set out of craft foam to create custom stamps. This is a great way to stretch your dies and use them in a new and unexpected way. I'm going to place my dies on craft foam and tape them with a piece of low-tech tape to make sure they stay in place. I'm going to use the regular cutting sandwich with the gray base plate and the white cutting plate, and will cut these out on my Artisan X-plorer machine, just as I would cut regular paper or cardstock. Once my die cutting is done, I'm going to take the die cut foam pieces out of the dies. I now need to temporarily adhere those to a flat surface to be able to use these as stamps. I'm going to use removable adhesive from scrapbook adhesives and will temporarily tape these to my clear blocks. Now we can go ahead and start stamping our design. So here I have several stamps that I created using dies from the Romantic Rose set. I have a large rose and two smaller roses, two leaves, and one additional element that I'm going to use to create a pattern. As for the inks, I'm going to use several colors from the Spellbinder Celebra'tions line, the light and dark purple colors, Pretty Plum and Lovely Lavender, and also a light and a dark green colors, Luscious Lime and Pixie Play. To create my pattern, I'm going to start in the middle of my white cardstock and will work my way out. I'm going to stamp one large rose and two smaller roses using the light and dark purple colors. I am not going to be cleaning my stamps in between colors, and you will notice that that will result in a third shade of purple on my card. Each of the rose clusters is going to be accompanied by a few leaves stamped in light and dark green for a little contrast. Wherever there is too much empty space, I'm also going to stamp the additional element using either a light or a dark purple. Notice that I'm also rotating my stamps every time I'm making an impression. This adds additional interest to my background. Working in this fashion, I will keep moving from the center towards the edges of my paper to create the entire background covered with stamped images. Now, these foam stamps can be reused several times. After you are done stamping, you can quickly clean them and store together with your dies for future use. After my stamping is done, I'm going to trim my stamped panel using the largest die from the A2 Matting Basics A set. As always, I'm going to place my die on my paper and tape it down in place using low-tech tape and run this through my Artisan X-plorer machine. To add a little bit of detail, I'm also going to emboss this piece using the tan embossing mat and pink embossing plate. Next, I'm going to work on my sentiment. First, I'm going to die cut and emboss a beautiful tag using the Pierce the Light die. I'm only going to use the outer die as I want to create a tag. If I wanted to have a frame, I would have used Bose dies from this set. Again, I'm going to place my die on my paper, tape it down in place, and send it through the machine. Next, switch to the embossing sandwich and also emboss it. Now I have a beautiful tag for my sentiment. Look at that detail. I love the little pierced swirls all around the tag. They make it look so very extra special. I can now go ahead and stamp my sentiment. To finish making my card, I'm going to trim the stamped panel into three pieces on my paper trimmer and will remove the middle one to create a negative space, which is going to be partially covered with a tag with a stamped sentiment. All of these pieces are going to be adhered to an A2 tub folding card base using foam adhesive to create extra dimension. Finally, I'm going to add a few purple gems next to the tag and finish making my project. Now here's another card idea using that same Romantic Rose set from Spellbinders. This time I use the dies in a usual way and die cut my pieces out of cardstock and pattern paper to create this beautiful yet simple card. Thank you for watching this video. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments section below. And be sure to subscribe to Spellbinders YouTube channel for more videos. Thank you for watching! Bye!